One downside I've discovered recently for going to see a PG-13 horror movie in theaters is that you have to deal with some rowdy teenagers. Underwater is directed by William Eubank and stars Kristen Stewart and Jessica Henwick. Underwater tells the story of an aquatic research team that is trying to escape an underwater rig that is quickly falling apart. It's January. This is not a historically great time for movies, so my expectations were not super high for this movie. It looked good in terms of the cast and the premise, but again, times like this, movies seem like they're gonna be good and then they're just bleh, especially horror. But this one was a pleasant surprise. I actually really enjoyed myself with this movie, so let's get right into it. So what worked? First and foremost, I actually really liked the characters in this movie. In horror movies, it's sometimes easy to not care about the characters as much because you're just watching them all getting picked off one by one. But these characters I actually felt invested in. The two that stood out for me were Nora, played by Kirsten Stewart, and Emily, played by Jessica Henwick. Jessica Henwick, last time I saw her was in Iron Fist as Colleen Wing, and this character is very different. She's a little more reserved and timid, but you see her trying to brave the terrors that await them in the ocean. This really showed the range that Jessica Henwick has as an actor, and I really look forward to see what she does post-Marvel. Kirsten Stewart, I think, is someone that's fallen under a lot of people's radar, especially when she was in the Twilight movies. People kind of wrote her off, but I think she's given some really great performances since then. And so if you are still holding her accountable for Twilight, then I think you should stop because she's been doing some great stuff. And she's great in this movie. I also thought Vincent Cassel did well as the crew's captain. Another thing I liked about this movie is that it felt like a video game. From the very beginning, they drop you right into the madness. You see immediately this rig is falling apart. Characters are rushing to try and figure out what they're supposed to do. And it's like they have different missions, different checkpoints they have throughout this journey of them trying to escape the rig and make it to safety. And I was following them the whole time. I felt super immersed in this undersea adventure, if you can call it, or undersea thriller. And I was really on the edge of my seat for a lot of these scenes. Speaking of being on the edge of my seat, this is a horror movie after all, and I actually thought they did the horror really well in this movie. In January horror movies, and even horror movies in general, there's sometimes a trap they fall into where they just keep throwing jump scares at you. They don't actually have substance. They don't have tension. This movie has it. They actually don't use that many jump scares, so when there is one, it does actually hit. And they also do a great job of building tension in these different scenes where they're walking through dark underwater areas. You don't know what's lurking around. These monsters are really hiding in the shadows, and you don't really see them that much. You see them a little bit in the trailer, but in the movie, a lot of the time they're obscured by the darkness of the water. You only see them really from the flashlights of their underwater suits. So when they do pop out and grab somebody, it's very, like you just jump. I also thought it was smart that you don't really see the monsters fully lit necessarily. They're always sort of obscured in darkness, which helps one hide CGI. So it doesn't really stand out to me as much because you're seeing it from a very shadowy, dark perspective. You're not really focused on the details. So it made the monsters feel a little more grounded. It made you not pay attention as much to the CGI. You're, again, more immersed in what's happening. For a PG-13 movie, they were able to get away with some very disturbing, horrific imagery. There is a limit to it, and of course, it's obscured by darkness, which is probably why they could get away with certain things, but these people were still going through it. They had to deal with some crazy stuff, and so even though it's a PG-13 movie, I still think there are some great, horrific elements that they threw in here. Earlier, I mentioned they drop you right into the chaos at the beginning of this movie, and it did mostly work, but one thing that I think could have made it a little bit better is that they didn't speed through so much sci-fi jargon. At first, I didn't understand what was really going on. They were just saying a lot of really crazy science-y words, and I was like, I was lost. But as the movie went on, I kind of picked up, and I'm like, all right, I see what they're doing now. But at first, it just seemed like they were throwing a lot of words at you, and you don't necessarily know what all of them mean in the context of this movie. Next thing, T.J. Miller. His character was the one I cared about the least. They really tried to make him the comic relief, and I got some chuckles from his jokes, but otherwise, I don't think he really added that much to this movie, and I think it would have been pretty much the same without him being there. And lastly, throughout the movie, especially towards the end, they were kind of hinting at something going on with this corporation that they're working for, how they treat the workers or how they react to this situation happening, and I would have liked to see them explore that a little bit more because that would have been a really interesting element to add to the horror, the suspense, giving it a little more substance. The verdict. I think Underwater is a great time. This movie was surprisingly enjoyable, gave me great scares, great performances, and the monsters look cool. So if you're looking for something to watch right now, and I know there's not a lot of options out there, I definitely recommend this one. So have you seen Underwater? What did you think about it? Let me know down in the comments. Also, don't forget to like this video, share it, and subscribe. By the way, my Cats review hit 2K this week. That is insane. But also, there's like 90% of the people who watched it not subscribing. So if you're watching this video and you like what I'm talking about, you like how I review movies, please subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.